We never can't not do nothing, and today we will replace brake pads on this road bicycle because these old ones are damaged. They are not worn, they are damaged, and first I will show while regularly inspecting a bicycle the damage that I saw and show what kind of brake pads I recommend. I think you can see these cracks. With brake pads that are like these, all in one piece, it is often the case that this material is more brittle and harder, so they have a bit less brake performance and they can crack sometimes, either because they're poor quality or when they get old, because the whole pad needs to, using the same material, fulfill both the function of braking and providing traction and to hold the whole system in place. What I recommend is another kind of brake. Here we have some, these are Shimano, but any brake manufacturer makes these. It's a two-piece system where you have like a whole metal casing that holds the brake shoes in place, and you have replaceable brake shoes. Let's open it and see how that looks like. Here it is, just one brake pad, and they usually have some sort of retaining pin. This is here like a screw, so you can unscrew it, and when you unscrew it, you can remove the brake pad. Now it's unscrewed and I can just easily push the brake pad out and replace it with a new one when the time comes. So this is the kind of system that allows easier adjustment and easier brake pad replacement, and generally allows for brake pads to be of softer material that brakes better, especially in the wet. And I prefer these kinds of system. I think they are more reliable and better overall. Now let's replace the pads. In order to replace the pad, we will need the following. New set of brake pads. Here we are replacing the whole system. After that, I will just be replacing these brake shoes, these inserts. That's what we'll need. We'll need some, in this case, I think it's 4 millimeter. Yes, it's 4 millimeter Allen wrenches. I have several different types depending on how easy it is to approach, and some others use 5 millimeter Allen wrenches. That's usually the standard, and that's about what we need for the tools, and we needed these cutters to open the package. Now let's look at the bicycle. Here is the front side of the bicycle, and you can often find on some, especially older models, sort of a quick release. Here it is like this design, so I can just push the brake lever a bit to unload it, then push this to the other side, and then I get more room to make the brake caliper a bit more open, so I can easily work on it. Also, some adjustment is usually present on the brake barrel, so you can tighten it and loosen it by twisting this in and out. Thus, by twisting it out, you make the cable more tense, and by turning this in, you effectively shorten the brake hose, making the cable more loose, giving it more slack. And some brake calipers have some quick release lever. This model does not have one. Okay, so I made things a bit easier for myself now. First, I need to remove the old brake shoes and then install the new ones. Let's get on with that. Okay, first I need to remove the old brake shoes. For that, I will use this 5 millimeter Allen wrench. Hold the bars in place and unscrew it. Okay, it's done. Now I need to remove the screw, the bolt. Hope you can see it. Okay, and it's out. Now I need to put the new pads in. I'm minding the orientation because I want this retainer pin to be on the back, because when brakes exert braking pressure, they are trying to stop the wheel from moving forward in this place. I want them to be pushing the brake pad into the holder, not trying to push it out, because it goes out. Here it's open, here it's closed. That's important thing to look out for. So I want them oriented like this and not the other way around. So I cannot put this one on the side far to you. I need to put it here. And that's what we'll do. Here I'm unscrewing the bolt completely. Now I can put the pad in place and screw it in. Before I do that, I need to pay attention to these like concave and convex adapters, and I'll explain that after I apply some anti-seize, which I like to do with most bolts when I mount them on bicycles. Here I've got some white anti-seize or mounting paste. You can read my article on those. I will put a link in this video's description, but I will apply a certain amount to the mounting bolts, and I also wish to lubricate the face of the bolt coming in so that it can be screwed and unscrewed easily. Now I'm putting this here, and this other part will go on the brake pad. I need to put it onto the brake pad. It has like some sort of convex area on the inside, which aligns with this, and that will provide me with the opportunity to slightly alter the angle of the brake pad compared to the relative to the rim, so they can do micro adjustments. This like a fin is used to easily install the wheel later, so it's got like a small guide to move the tire away from the brake pad and to make the wheel installment a bit quicker and easier. Important if you're racing. Now I'm putting the pad in place and I'm screwing it in. And now before I tighten it, you can either use the brake lever or your hands to hold it in position to make some initial setup. But before I do that, I will put the pad on the other side and then I will try to tune them. All right, I've mounted the pads. Now before I do fine tuning and adjustment, first thing I do is to re-engage the brake lever to operate in its normal range by disabling this quick release. Okay, it's good now. Now let's take a look at the brake pads. Okay, here my goal is to have them both parallel to the rim and to be as low as possible without missing this area for brakes, because if I put them too high when they engage and as they wear, they tend to ride even higher, so they will risk catching the tire and getting a flat. So what I want to do is release this a bit so they can have some wiggle room, then look at if I can easily and nicely make it aligned properly. This looks okay. Checking it from all the sides. All right, now I can try to tighten it and see what I've got. Sometimes they might rotate in the direction that you are tightening the bolt, and in that case you have to use your finger to hold it in place as you're tightening it. And this brake seems well aligned. I am paying special attention to have it not come closer to the rim at an angle, but to have them parallel, or if I wish to make it like really, really perfectly aligned, I will make the rear end be a bit more further away to the rim compared to the front end, like having them at an angle. I wish to get something like this, which is perfect. I'm exaggerating it, but that's, I don't want this by any means, and I either go for parallel or slightly angled. That can be achieved by placing a zip tie at the rear end before aligning it, and then when the zip tie is removed, it will remain a bit at an angle. But during braking, they will wear at that angle slightly. So when I do this, I usually go for the parallel. And this one is good. I will now fix the opposite side, tighten it, and then do fine adjustment of the amount of play. All right. What I will try to do now is to adjust the amount of play. I want this lever movement to be sufficient to allow for enough braking without the lever hitting the bars going all the way, but I don't want it to be too little as it is now, so that I cannot get enough braking leverage. And often you can use this like a fine tuning mechanism and then turn it out as the brake pads wear. But this starting situation is pretty with very little play. You can compare this to the other lever and see how much play there is. A lot more, which makes it a bit more useful. And here we have very little play. With these kinds of brake pads, I will need to a bit to loosen the cable a bit, which is what I will do now. Okay, I had to replace the brake pinch bolt and the nut because they were damaged and could not hold this tightly. So back on to the drawing board. Let's see now. Okay, needs a bit more tightening. Okay, let's see now. Okay, I think this is it. I have enough room to adjust this as the pads wear out, and the initial lever pull is somewhat optimal. Yeah, I think this is good. And see if it holds. Yes, I think it's good. It stays in place. Okay, now let's see the other bolts just to double check. All right, now before we call it a day, we have one more configuration to do, and that is to make sure that both pads touch the rim simultaneously. With these modern brakes, brake calipers, they are self-aligning, so if they have a certain preset position, they will stick to it. And you can see probably in the video how this wheel is moved a bit towards your left hand side as I brake. And the right hand side pad touches the rim before the left hand side has touched it. And that is usually configured, fine-tuned using a screw. And now I will tightening this screw moves them to one direction, and loosening it moves them to the opposite direction. And here, okay, I think I've got it. Now they are moving simultaneously, and you can see as one of them touches the rim, the other one touches it also. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, I'm set to go riding now. Thank you for watching this video. As always, do try this at home. You don't have to be a professional bicycle mechanic in order to replace your brake pads and fix your road bicycle. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Cheers.